Yes, hello learners outside there. Nice to meet you once again on this forum of online learning. I have very few minutes here and I would like to use them by going directly to the content we have today. You remember the other time we were discussing about parts of speech. We talked about the number, we listed them. We singled one out. Can you remind me the one we singled out? Yeah, that very answer you are thinking about is actually correct. I'm sure you are thinking about adverbs. There are 8 parts, but that's the part we picked. Now we looked at the definition of adverbs. It said adverbs are words that modify or tell us more about a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. We went ahead and looked at kinds of adverbs. Say we have, could you mention those kinds before I can write them here? Don't check in the book, just mention them. I'm sure the first one you have in your mind should be adverbs of place, adverbs of time, adverbs of frequency, adverbs of degree. Adverbs of degree. We have adverbs of duration, and lastly, we have adverbs of manner. We had 6 guys, and I believe here we have 6 of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's good. If you had that in your mind, your answers were correct. But quickly, I normally like beginning with a spelling activity. I would like you to write the following words very fast. Get a pen and a book. I would like to check your spelling there. Remember, in English, spelling is one of the important aspects. Children know answers, but they find challenges with spellings. Write the following words. Number one, write the word truly, from the word true. Jesus was truly a son of God. Number two, write the word voluntarily, from the word volunteer. I'm doing voluntary work, therefore I'm doing it voluntarily. Next word, write the word skillfully, from the word skill. If you have a skill, then you do something skillfully. Next word, write for me the word energetically, from the word energy. He did his work energetically. Next word, write for me the word accidentally, from the word accident. Accidentally should be first. Next one, write for me the word mercifully. Mercifully. Next word, write for me the word noisily, from the word noise. Noisily. Next word, write for me the word publicly, from the word public. From the word public. Let's quickly have the correction of those words I've just given to you. Our first word was truly, coming from the word true. Someone who has failed has here letter E. If that is you, make that correction and write your answer on the other side. Our word number two was voluntarily. Voluntarily comes from the word voluntary. Our next word was skillfully, from the word skill. Skillfully, that's the correct spelling of skillfully. Next word was actually energetically, from the word energy. If you do something while having energy, you are doing it energetically. Our next word was mercifully. I'm sure, mercifully. Our next word was publicly. Publicly. And lastly, our word was noisily. If you failed any of those words, please make the corrections. Now, of the six kinds we have here of adverbs, I'm going to single out one. And remember, if you are skinning a goat, if you have ever skinned any, you begin from any side. And even if I've listed them here, I'm going to use any, not necessarily the number one. And for today, I'm choosing adverbs of manner. Adverbs of manner. And I would like to pose a question to you. What are adverbs of manner? How would you define adverbs of manner? In simple terms, as you think of the definition, this is what you just have to know. Adverbs of manner, just hear the definition, I'm not writing on the keyboard, just hear it. Adverbs of manner tell us how an action will is taking, or took place. In that definition, the key word you should get is actually how. Adverbs of manner tell us how. In other words, adverbs of manner answer the question of how. Answer the question of how. We are going to go ahead and have some of these examples of adverbs of manner. Where can we get these examples? In fact, the words I gave you in a spelling activity, all of them are examples of manner. They answer the question of how. How did he handle you? He handled me mercifully. How did he lift the desk? He lifted the desk energetically. How did he kick the ball? He kicked the ball skillfully. How did he behave in class? He behaved in class noisily. How was it done? It was done publicly. Examples of adverbs of manner actually are many, but these are some of the examples. I'm sure you can also list some, and you can list where you are there. Another aspect I would like us to have a look at is actually the formation of adverbs of manner. That is our next subheading. Let me write it here. Formation of adverbs of manner. Formation of adverbs of manner. Most of these adverbs of manner are actually formed from adjectives. They are formed from adjectives, and I believe you know how to define an adjective, and we are going to see how some of these adverbs of manner are formed and the ways they are formed. Let's look at the first way. How do you form adverbs of manner? Like this one we have here. The first way I would like us to have a look at, actually, let me call this one part A. We can form adverbs of manner by simply adding ly on the adjective. What do I mean? Let's have some examples here. We shall have this side adjective, and this side we shall have the adverb that we are forming. And we have said by simply adding ly. And I'll give you a few examples here. Our first example here that we have this word proper. This word is an adjective, but we can form an adverb from this word proper. And remember, the heading says by simply adding ly. And adverbs of manner answer the question of how. How did he sit? He sat properly. This one is an adverb, this one is an adjective. Right? Our next word here is the word correct. This is an adjective. Which adverb can it give us? Go here by simply adding ly. Here our answer could be correctly. He answered his word correctly. I'm not going to list all, I'll give some here and you complete by yourself from there. One of them is here wrong. Complete that by yourself. Another one I have here is fair. This is the adjective, form for me the adverb from those ends. This is an adjective, complete and put for me the adverb. Quick. Put for me the adverb the other side. Silent. Complete with the correct adverb. Here I have careless. Careless. Complete with the correct adverb. So this is one of the ways of forming adverbs of manner. And here it is actually quite simple. Let's look at another way of forming adverbs of manner. That was part A. This is part B now. This is part B. We have other unique adjectives. We have other unique adjectives. We shall have a look at them here. Can also form adverbs of manner by adding ly to make lly, to make lly, and this one makes applies for adjectives that end with letter L. Adjectives that end with letter L. I think the other side I forgot to write one examples. Here, let me put here examples to explain that point. I'll have this side. Here the adjective. And here I'll have the adverb. Adjective then, adverb. Can you give me some of those examples? Adjectives that end with letter L. When forming the adverb, you double the L. Which answer do you have in your mind? Yeah, if you had any of these words, then your answer is correct. Think about this adjective social. If you are a social person, then whatever you do it socially. Huh? Let's have another example. Here we have this word legal. If you are in the legal department, then whatever you do it legally. And here the point to note is, here you have double L. You have double L. A child who is failing, or someone who is failing here actually puts here on the single L. And this is very examinable, especially by Uganda National Examination Board. Let's look at some of these examples still, of these words that end with letter L. One of them is actually, have this word, grammatical. Grammatical. What will it give you? It will give you grammatically. Grammatically. The rest you are going to complete because you have known how we are completing these words. We are doubling the L. Another example here, complete this for me. Mental. If you have someone has a mental problem, then that person is disturbed mentally. Complete that in a correct way. Another word I have here is the careful. This also ends with letter L. If you are careful, you do something carefully. Another one we have here is skillful. If you are skillful, then whatever you do, you do it skillfully. Let's have another one here. That is official. If you are doing something in an official way, then you are doing it. You are doing it officially. I hope you are able to complete all those words correctly. I think let me add one last one here. We have this one, accidental. If you do something in an accidental manner, then it was done accidentally. Here my marking point is on LLY. Can you complete that for me correctly? Let's look at another way of forming adverbs of manner. This is actually now going to be the third way. The third way of forming adverbs of manner. Here we are going to focus on adjectives that end with, now as let me say, by adding a LLY adjectives. Ending with IC. Examples. This side shall have adjective and this side adverb. Can you please give me some of those examples? Are they coming in your head? Okay. Compare with my video I'm giving here. Adjectives that end with IC form their adverbs by adding A, L, L, Y. Here are some of our examples. First example here is the word energetic. And we looked at this word earlier on. If you are energetic, then you do things energetically. See how we are forming this word. Add here A, L, L, Y. Like you have said here. Now you can be able to complete for me this. Domestic. No. Domestic. Domestic can say things are being done domestically. Domestically. Another example we have here is actually dramatic. Something dramatic is done dramatically. Dramatically. I believe you can now be able to complete these words for me. One of them is specific. Specific. I believe you can complete this one well. Specific. Can complete that well for me. Another one we have is optimistic. 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 Another one we have here is heroic. Heroic. When you look at our subheading, we say adjectives ending with IC, you just add A, L, L, Y. I believe you can be able to complete for me these words well. However, there's something you should note here. And what I want you to note, I'm actually going to call it an exception. Even if we have said that adjectives ending with IC, you add A, L, L, Y. We have one unique adjective here, and that is the word public. Public. This word is unique. If you are writing its spelling, you don't follow this rule. That's why I'm calling it an exception. So this word public will give you the word publicly. Just add there, L, Y, and that's the correct answer. Let's look at another way of forming adverbs of manner. And this is going to be number 4, that is part D. This is part D. This is another way of forming adverbs of manner. And we are going to say, you can also form adverbs of manner by dropping E. By dropping E and adding L-Y on adjectives ending L-E. This is another unique way of forming adverbs. If you have adjectives that end with L-E and you are forming adverbs, what do you do? You drop letter E, like we are saying here, and you add L-Y. Let's have a look at the examples here. These are our examples. Think of some other like this. Here we have adjective, adverb. Yes, our first one is going to be the word simple. When you are forming an adverb from this word simple, you drop letter E. Meaning this word simple is going to give us the adverb as in simply. All these are adverbs of manner. We have the word able. If you are able to do something, then you do it ably. You do it ably. We have the word terrible. Terrible. Follow the symbol, drop letter E, just drop letter E. This word is going to give you the word terribly. Can you add one more examples? Okay, we have a word like miserable. This is an adjective ending with L-E. An adverb formed from here is miserably. He looked at me miserably. These examples are many. You can look up in your dictionary, you can do more research and have this list here expanded. But I would like you to complete these words for me. In the same manner, gentle, form for me the adverb there from this word, gentle. Have a word like humble, form the adverb from such a word. Follow the same rules of forming adverbs. However, we also have an exception here. An exception we have, we will see it. Exception. We have this adjective true. This is an adjective true. It's an adjective. But when forming the adverb, when forming the adverb, you drop letter E. And yet, it doesn't end with L-E. That's why I'm calling it an exception. And people always misread the spelling of this word true. So here, the correct spelling of this word is truly. It doesn't end with L-E, but just drop letter E. That's why I'm calling it an exception. That's why I'm calling it an exception. Let's look at another way of forming adverbs of manner. Another way of forming adverbs of manner. This one I'm going to call it way number 5. Here, shall say by adding ly on some adjectives ending with E but not L-E. If that point is difficult for you to understand, let me make it easier by giving you some examples here. Don't just grab that all adjectives ending with letter E, you just drop it and add L-Y. That's not true. We have some unique adjectives here to form adverbs in a unique way. Hear what I mean? Okay, this side we shall have adjective and this side adverb. Here I mean adjectives like the word nice. From here you're going to form the adverb nicely. Nicely. He smiled nicely. Don't drop letter A. This one is unique. Another category of this group is the word rude. This one gives you the word rudely. Don't drop letter A. I will have words like polite, complete in the same manner. Immediate. Immediate. Gives you immediately. Not dropping A. Love. This one gives you love. Lovely. Not dropping E. Wise. Gives you wisely. Not dropping letter E. So this is another unique way of forming adverbs of manner by simply adding L-Y on adjectives ending with letter E. Let's look at another one quickly here. We are almost concluding. Another one, another record for me, that was, I think we are correct letters of the alphabet, A, B, C, D, E, A, B, C, D, number 5, A, B, C, D, this was like B, part E. Let's go to part F. Here we shall say by grouping, Y. And adding I L Y. This one is only applicable on adjectives that end with letter Y. We are going to have some examples here. Here we shall have the adjective, and this side we shall have the adverb. I'll give a few examples here. First one is heavy. This one heavy is going to give you the adverb heavily. Drop Y into I and add L Y, like our subheading says. We have the word lazy. This one will give you the word lazily, like you are saying there. I think you can now complete from this list. Have noisy. If you are noisy, then you do things noisily. If you are lousy, you do things lousily. This list continues. We have a word like happy. If you are happy, then you do something happily. If you are angry, you do something angry. This is our last, actually, this is our last part on the formation of adverbs of manner. This is our last part. This one I'm not going to call it part G, but I'll just make it a special subheading. I'll call it forming adverbs from nouns. Sometimes can be the examiner's choice. The examiner can choose to put a noun in brackets, not an adjective. That is, actually, if you are used to forming adverbs from adjectives, the examiner can change the style of setting the question. Let's quickly have a look here. This is what I mean. Let's have some examples. So this side we shall have noun, and this side adverb. Here are some examples. You may have this word, anger. This word is a noun, not an adjective. Anger. Which adverb can we come from here? Don't just come and so we add L-Y, no. Here you make a lot of changes. The word anger should change from a noun to an adjective, which is angry. The word angry, written in this manner. Then from here from the adverb, which is the angry. You're saying that. Let's add on. May have the word noise. This is a noun. Our adverb is going to be noisy. Don't just come here and add L-Y. You may have a word like day. Day. This one gives you the word daily. I'm going to put some here. I think you complete. If you like making fun, then you do things funnily. Do things funnily. This is a noun, but you are forming an adverb. You may have the word brute. If you behave like a brute, then you do things brutally. You do things brutally. You'll complete this for me. Love, which adverb comes from here. Joy, which adverb comes from here. Now, I would like to end with an activity. For you here. Yes, hello learners, we can now have the activity. Today we have actually been quick. I want you at least to handle some good amount of work on adverbs. That is why my speed actually has been high for the day, unlike the other time. I wanted to engage with a lot of work. Now, I would like you to answer for me this activity. Simple. The subheading is the order instructions form. Form adverbs of manner from the following words. Form adverbs of manner from the following words. Number one is quick. I'll first answer you that. Quick. We give you quickly. Then you are going to complete the rest of my activity here. Here I have true. Or number three is comfortable. Number four is sympathy. Which adverb is formed from here? Sympathy. Number five is accident. Accident. Number six here is faithful. Faithful. Number seven is mercy. Form an adverb from here. Number eight is lousy. Thank you so much for listening to me, learners from outside there. I wish you a nice stay and above all, stay safe, wash your hands, and practice social distancing, and above all, follow the guidelines from the President and the Minister of Health. Thank you so much. God bless you.